So yeah, this is my second attempt at this. I did notice that putting the tailstock up, and that's still a bit punky. I did not use blue on this, as you can see the colors in it. I'm pretty sure the blue was an issue. So let's see. I did yellow, and right now I just want to take this off till I get to the wood. And that's all I really intend to do. I might cut the mortise in this also on the bottom and then fill it again, but I'm not sure how that's gonna work out, so we'll see. I don't quite know what to do at the moment. But let me get this flattened out so that we're not wobbling around so much. Alright, so I'm looking for the wood that I haven't found yet. I found a little bit there. We'll keep going till I find it. Say I found it. Oh, is that wet? That's not wet, is it? No. I thought the blue might be wet. I had problems with the blue. Just the blue. So, as you noticed, I didn't use blue to do the second layer there. Okay, I didn't drill that hole, but like I can't get away from the damn hole. I didn't do that. I'm not quite sure what to do about it. I really don't know. I think I'm gonna put some UV resin down in it and see if I can cure it or something. I don't I suppose I could try to pour some clear resin down in it and see what happens. Maybe we'll do that. Yeah, that's kind of interesting, isn't it? So currently, I'm just trying to slope this. Oops, you can't see it. Focus. There we go. So I have a ridge right here because I'm cutting into here. So I need to smooth this out. I also need to drop it in a little bit here because it's pretty flat right there. I need to make that shiny spot go away right there, which it's almost all the way gone. Clearly the UV, or not UV resin, but the cactus juice did not cure again. You can see it's not as bad as the first time, but wow. So anyways, we're going to make that go away, slope this out just a little bit more. I'm really hoping you can see the separations in colors. I can see them better now. There's the yellow, the green, blue, into purple, and then into red. There seems to be a lot of purple, or orange. A little bit of yellow to green, and then back into blue again. So I like that effect so far. So I got it, like I said, I got a ridge right here. I still need to get rid of that right there in there. And yeah, I'm just taking my time. You notice I went to carbide because I was having some vibration issues with the bowl gouges, and the carbide seems to be cutting better. So quick sandy sand with some 80 grit. I'm gonna put a resin coat on this again because it's so punky. I think that's the only way it's gonna look good. So I'll put probably a 2-to-1 on it, and then go with a art resin over top of that. I just want to smooth it out just a little bit, and that's about it, I think. Yeah. forgot a light.
Can you see through it? All right. Well, you can't really see through it. So anyways, here's my rainbowy looking bowl. So you can see the blue. I mixed that way too dark. I didn't think about it. I just dipped it in there, wiggled it, and I expected it to be a little more translucent than it was. But so you can see blue, green, yellow, orange, and the red, and then the purple, of course, is, I don't know if you can see it, but. And then I dye stabilized it also, which I think, if I didn't get it hot enough on the inside, my cactus juice is just, because it was like wet on the inside, and it's been months, and I cooked it for a few days at, you know, over 200 degrees, so it should have cured that. Other than that, the finish is nice. It's a little wonky because it was wet. So that's why I went with the route with the finish on it. I do like going to the art resin, I guess you want to call it, maker's resin. But I have to make sure that I don't put too much on it, because I came in and there was a stalagmite going around in circles, and I didn't have the camera with me, so I just kind of gooped it off real quick, and I come out and I put another really thin coat on it the next day once I sanded it down. So other than that, I mean, I got two coats of art resin on it, which is okay, because there was a spot that had one I think in the red over here, where it's soaked into the wood still. But yeah, so put my logo in the bottom in gold. It's in there. It's not great, but it's in there. I think the plastic actually floated in the bottom of it, and I've never done that before. It usually stays stuck down. But anyways, so that's my project for today. Box elder in a rainbowy looking color. I don't know if I can. Hang on, guys. I'm taking a screenshot for my for my thumbnail. Awesome. Yeah, anyway, so if you liked it, give her a thumbs up. If you didn't, well, you know, nobody has to like it, and you can give her a thumbs down. Pictures at the end. Y'all have a great week, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.